Hey everyone, so it has been a minute since I have been on here. We were closed for the COVID-19. We've been closed since March and we have now been reopened for a week now, and I'm super super happy to be back to working and helping everyone out. But today I actually wanted to jump on and just do a quick video, and I wrote myself notes, so you'll see me kind of looking down and reading. But just 7 tips that basically are good professional house cleaning tips. These are going to be awesome for you to be able to not only save time whenever you're cleaning, but also doing it the right way, in other words. So the first one that I wanted to talk about was cleaning from top to bottom and then left to right and then simultaneously. I know I say that crazy, right? Like I can't ever say that the right way. But basically what that means is you're working from the top to the bottom, because obviously dust falls. So if you're cleaning like in a bedroom and you have your ceiling fan, you don't want your dust on your ceiling fan to fall down on something like your dresser that you just dusted. So you're going to be saving time in that aspect without having to go back and be re-cleaning items that you have already previously cleaned. So top to bottom, and then going from left to right. Now you can also go from right to left, but either way, you're always going to want to go around the room. So like if you go from left to right, you're going to be hitting every corner and every section. And that way you're kind of creating a pattern, and you're not ever missing anything. Everything is wiped and cleaned and perfect, right? So that is my first tip. My second tip is going to be to have everything that you need with you. So that's going to be all your cleaning supplies, whatever tools that you're going to need, like maybe your ceiling fan cleaner or your wand to dust the blinds, different things like that. You want to have all of your products and tools together, and you're going to put that in the center of your room. Reason being is because if you think about it, if you're having to walk back and forth from room to room, getting different things that you might need, you are spending so much extra time doing that. So keeping everything localized just in the center of whatever room that you're working, is going to save you so much time and make it a lot easier on you. The next thing, tip number three, is going to be to let your products do the job. So what I mean by that is there's been many, many times that I've gotten products and I have gone to use them and I have said, oh man, this like cleaner is horrible. It doesn't work. A number one thing for me would be like a bathtub cleaner or a shower cleaner. You spray it and then you wipe it and it doesn't do nothing. And you think, oh, this product is horrible. But you need to let the product sit. Be sure. It sounds stupid, right? But you need to read the directions on the back of your cleaning bottles. It will tell you what you need to do. It'll tell you how long that the product needs to sit in order to actually do its job. So if you've given up on a product before, give it another go and see if it works better for you. Or maybe the product that you're currently using, if you give it a little bit of extra time to actually sit and do its job, you might be more impressed and you might have to scrub quite less because it's actually had time to work. Also, keep in mind that if you're using a product that has a disinfecting product in it, you need to make sure, obviously, that you're letting it sit so that it can actually be disinfecting your surface. Brain pop, right? Sounds so obvious, but nobody does it. All right, so that was tip four. Tip number five, you guys. Tip five, start gentle. So immediately people are going to always go to the products, that have the big slogans on them, like super degreaser or the slogans that make it look like it's the really most powerful cleaning agent that you can be using. Start gentle before you go straight to the harsher chemicals. And that way that you can actually use the gentle products if you use them correctly. You're reading directions on the back of your bottle, right? So the gentle products really and truly and honestly can often work just as good, if not better, than the harsher chemicals, and then you're not using those harsh chemicals. Now, obviously, if you have somebody who you're cleaning up with, got sick, like maybe your kid got sick on the bathroom floor, or you just have a really, really greasy stove top, in those cases, yes, go to a harsher chemical. But a gentle product is going to do good. And to be honest, a lot of people think that their houses are much dirtier than they actually really are. Then we're going to go to our next tip. We are going to go to tip number five, I believe this is. Let's see. One, two, three, four, five. Oh, six. Six. No, five. The eye level test, you guys. So an eye level test is, if you can imagine, you go and you clean your kitchen counter, right? If you're looking down at your kitchen counter, looks clean to you. But if you actually get down and look eye level, you will be like shocked at all the things that you miss. So doing an eye level check on your countertops especially is going to be a big cleaning thing for you to see what you actually have been missing. The next tip number six, is using a certain pattern. Now, this is I've taken this slogan from another lady, but she calls it the S pattern. And what that basically means is that in general, we have always been taught, or we see the commercials or whatnot, where you're wiping and you're wiping, side to side, in a little circles, especially like on a mirror, or you're cleaning a stainless steel refrigerator door, stuff like that. You're gonna find that you are leaving more streaks and actually spreading the dirt around in a circle. So you're cleaning, so like you're cleaning this way, it's clean, 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 dirty, 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 right? So you're going to use the S pattern, and what that means is, so you start at the top, right? And you're going like this, right? Just zigzagging across until you're all the way at the bottom. You're going to find that you actually have way less streaks, and you're going to find that you're going to get better results by doing it this way. So give it a try. Let me know how it works. And then the last tip number seven. Tip number seven is just going to be all about making things look nice and tidy and organized and just pleasing to the eye in general. So I tell all the girls and guys that work for me, all of our crews, that whenever you're going to a house, you could spend, hours in a house cleaning, but if the house is not pleasing to the eye, the customer's not going to even notice the cleaning that you actually did. So it could be dust free, could be, no soap scum, no grime, whatever, no ha facial hair in the man's sink. All those things can be taken care of, but if it doesn't look like you actually, took the time to make things tidy and eye pleasing, it doesn't really make a difference, if that makes sense. So it's what you need to do is line things up. You're going to line them up like basically either perpendicular or parallel, right? So say you have a bunch of bottles on a bathroom counter. You're going to want to line those up, stack them nicely in a line, perpendicular or parallel. So that way, when somebody walks in, they're looking at it and it looks nice and tidy and organized. So hopefully these seven tips, I don't know where I got three from, but the seven tips that I just went over with you guys will help. Let me know if any of them are like give you a mind blown, like that type of thing. I would love to hear from you guys, or if you have any tips that you wanted to throw out there, be sure you comment below. And again, we are happy to be back and look forward to taking care of all of you guys. You guys have a great rest of your week. Bye.